In this Changing Accounting Systems video, we're going to learn all about setting up undeposited funds. Undeposited funds setup is the last part of setting up your accounts receivable. Undeposited funds is another peripheral or subsidiary area of data that must match the balance of an account in the trial balance chart of accounts. And we know the name of the account that everything has to equal to is called undeposited funds. The details inside the account include checks, cash, and credit card swipes from payments of customer invoices. And it also includes checks, cash, and credit card swipes from sales receipts that we previously recorded. Undeposited funds has to be set up after account receivable and accounts payable have been set up, but before the main setup journal entry. It comes after those two things because it's really part of the accounts receivable setup, because no matter what, we might have some payments for invoices that have not yet been deposited as of the transfer date. There are only three possible things that can be in undeposited funds at the moment we switch over from the old system to the new. It could include invoice payments to invoices that are currently open as of the transfer date. It could include money we collected from sales receipts that we recorded in the previous system, or it could include invoice payments to closed invoices. Customers gave us money and we have already applied the money to past invoices, but the check or the credit card swipe would still be sitting in undeposited funds. Now, for invoice payments to open invoices, in other words, anything sitting in undeposited funds that has already been applied to invoices that are still currently open, we have already recorded them into undeposited funds as part of the accounts receivable setup. All we have to do is make sure that they are received into the undeposited funds account and not the cash and bank account as we're recording those payments in our new system. If you record a payment to the wrong deposit account, you must change them one by one till the details match the old system. In other words, if you were setting up the new system and you put in a customer payment that you put in as deposited cash in bank, but it's really supposed to be in undeposited funds or vice versa, you have to go and fix it so it matches the old system. So for both QuickBooks Desktop and QuickBooks Online, let's take a look at what's in the old system and compare it to what we have in the new system after the accounts receivable and accounts payable setup. First, we'll compare the old system with the new system using QuickBooks Desktop. Then we'll do it again for good measure with QuickBooks Online. So for QuickBooks Desktop, the primary window is the new system and the secondary window behind it is the old system. So if we take a look at the trial balance in the old system, it has the old numbers, just like we finished with at the end of the QuickBooks Online course. But if we look at undeposited funds in the old system, and we can see it's only $4,200, with QuickBooks Desktop, you can double-click, and you can actually see in the account which ones have already been deposited. The desktop version includes this column called Cleared, and anything that's checked inside the undeposited funds account has already been deposited into the bank. So right now, when we look at the old system or the remaining numbers at the end of the old system, the only item that does belong in undeposited funds is this sale receipt from March 14th. It's the only one because we received a check for this sale receipt and not cash. So the instructions told us not to deposit it. It only told us to deposit the cash. So this sale receipt with the check that we received from Candy for this sale receipt should be sitting in undeposited funds, because that's what we finished with the old system. Now, when we look at the new system, we can take a look at the trial balance and see that after we set up only accounts receivables and payables, undeposited funds was instead $1,680, not the $4,200. And when we double click and see why is it $1,680, what we actually see are three payments that don't belong there. These three payments were the mistake that I was referring to in the previous video. In the previous video, when we set up accounts payable, we were supposed to record these payments as deposited into the bank already. But I purposely had you make the mistake by having it go into undeposited funds so that you can experience fixing this mistake. So all we have to do is remove, in the new system, we have to remove from undeposited funds what does not belong there. So all we have to do is double click the payment, change the deposit account to cash and bank, and save. Yes. And then notice it disappears from undeposited funds, change it to cash and bank because it is in cash and bank as of the transfer date, do it to the last mistake, and now all of the payments that have been applied to open invoices have been properly deposited in the bank. And now you can see the negative balance of cash has gone lower negative because we increased the balance by depositing those items from undeposited funds. And now you can see undeposited funds now has zero as we continue to correct it. The next thing that was in undeposited funds in the old system that's missing from the new system is this sale receipt right here. If we go to the old system, remember we said that the balance of undeposited funds in the old system as of the transfer date was $4,200. And that's because we received a check for the March 14th sale receipt from Candy. And that's the only thing that's supposed to be there. Well, fixing that is very easy. You see, when it comes to sales receipts that were in undeposited funds as of the transfer date, it's the same idea as setting up accounts receivable or setting up accounts payable. You just enter them as you see them and make sure that they get recorded into the undeposited funds account. That's it. Now, if you remember, as you record them, other numbers besides undeposited funds will change, usually income accounts. But you don't have to worry about that because we will adjust for those changes as we make the main setup journal entry to correct the balances. The same way we did in the original video when there were results left over and we made our debit and credit for the difference between what was left over and what were the balances in the old system. So there's only one example of a sale receipt in this case that we need to enter, so let's go ahead and enter it and make the balance of undeposited funds finally correct. Now, if we look at what's in the old system, we can see that when we open undeposited funds, that sale receipt that we were talking about was March 14th, 2017 for Candy, 14 video hours. So that's what we will put in the new system. We will make a sale receipt for March 14th of 2017. And we will choose Candy Charles, just like we know, video and 14. Make sure that the deposit account is undeposited funds because it was a check. I don't remember which check number it was. It doesn't matter. But now in the new system, when we open the trial balance, ladies and gentlemen, undeposited funds now has the same balance in the new system that it did in the old system. And what you're looking at right here are the numbers in the new system after setting up receivables, payables, and undeposited funds. And it is these money amounts that we would subtract from the money amounts in the old system. It is the money amounts right here in the old system minus the money amounts, minus the money amounts left over in the new system from after receivables, payables, and undeposited funds. And in our case, these are the numbers we would use to subtract to find the money amounts of the main setup journal entry. And exactly what we did to prepare undeposited funds in the desktop version, I am now going to show you exactly what we would do to fix it in QuickBooks Online. Now let's make those exact same corrections in your QuickBooks Online system. Let's go to the new system here, and let's imagine we finished setting up receivables and payables. So the best thing to do is open reports and open your trial balance, which is the results of all transactions regardless of date. Now here's undeposited funds. Notice when we open up the undeposited funds accounts in QuickBooks Online, notice that there are no check marks. In other words, there is no way to find out in the QuickBooks Online system which ones have already been deposited and which ones have not been deposited just by looking at the check marks. The only way that you can know is, well, you open the undeposited funds and you know it's there, but you can't tell what has been deposited. There are other ways of doing that in QuickBooks Online. I'm going to make this a tiny bit wider. Okay, I hope you can see everything. But basically, we do the same things in QuickBooks Online to prepare undeposited funds that we just did with the desktop version. Double-click the payment, choose cash and bank because that's where this payment was at the moment we switched over. Okay, no thank you. Good. Got to do it, you know, one by one. Click the payment, change it to cash and bank because that's where it was at the moment that we switched over. Okay, and then one last one. And now undeposited funds will be zero after we switch over this last payment. But we know that undeposited funds is not zero because if we go back to the trial balance, we know that we're supposed to put a sales receipt for March 14th from Candy for 14 video hours. So let's go ahead and record that sales receipt. Sales. Okay. Actually, you have to click the plus sign and come over to sales receipt like we learned in the QuickBooks Online course. And the date was March 17th of 2017. That's the year we're working in. The customer was Candy Charles, and it was video, and it was quantity 14. And that's what made the $4,200. And make sure that this goes into undeposited funds because this sale receipt was undeposited at the moment that we changed accounting systems. So now that we save it, and now that we go back to the trial balance, you can see the trial balance here in the QuickBooks Online account is the same as the trial balance in the new system with the QuickBooks desktop. It has the exact same numbers in undeposited funds, cash and bank, and everything else. And now these are the numbers we will subtract from the ending balances of the old system to be able to find out the amounts of the main setup journal entry.